स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ 11th स्टैंडर्ड इन आरुमुगम एकेडमी, लेट मी गिव यू द रिविजन ऑफ द फर्स्ट यूनिट. यू नो वी हैव टेकन अबाउट 13 क्लासेस इंक्लूडिंग दिस. लेट मी गिव यू वॉट एवर द लेसन्स दैट वी डेल्ट, वॉट एवर वी डिड इन दिस फर्स्ट यूनिट. Let me give you the summary of it. Let me give you a revision of it. All right, good. My dear students, in the first class, we introduced the content of 11th standard. You know, we came to know that there are totally 6 units are there, and all the units were explained. In the same class, you were exposed to the public question paper, and the way the questions are asked were explained to you. Following, I explained to you clearly what would be the exercises for the one mark exercises, all right, for the one words. Dear students, in this lesson, what we dealt was the 2-mark questions, 3-mark questions and 5-mark questions. The syllabus was given to you. In the same lesson, we dealt with what kind of the general questions would be asked in the 5 marks. Students, after the explanation of the question paper and after the explanation of the syllabus of 11th standard, we started our lesson, the first unit, first prose, namely The Portrait of a Lady, written by Kushwant Singh, which says about the bond and the affection between the grandmother and the grandchild. In the next class, we saw the continuation of the prose. In the next video, we came to the conclusion of the story and we gave the explanation of the whole prose. Then after that, we saw the textual exercises, namely the questions and answers that has been given at the back of the prose. After that, my dear students, we saw some exercises, some practice on the synonyms and antonyms. Exclusively for the synonyms and antonyms, we spent our class. In the next video or in the next class, what we did is, you know, at the back of the prose, we have lot of exercises given in the book, and we dealt all those exercises. In the next lesson, we dealt with the tenses, which we saw what present tense, past tense, future tense, and their usages. All right, all those things we saw. My dear students, in the following video lesson, what we did was we started the poem Once Upon a Time, written by Gabriel Okaro, which talked about being fake in the world. All right. And then in the next video, we saw the Poetry Appreciation, ERC, and paragraph questions for the poem. And the exercises that are expected in the board examinations were dealt with. My dear students, in the next class, we saw After 20 Years as a video in English. And then the same story, namely After 20 Years, in the explanation in Tamil was given to you, the narration was done in Tamil. And it was shared to you and for the, especially for the Tamil medium students. Then in the class or in the video, the explanation, paragraph by paragraph, word by word, was given to you for After 20 Years. At the end of this class, let me give you the paragraph of After 20 Years. Suppose you are asked to write a paragraph on the short story After 20 Years, you can make use of this paragraph. All right, let me dictate, or you can slowly, you can write it in your notebook. Good. Let me read it. After 20 years, within quote, is a story that opens with a policeman on night patrol. It was nearly 10 at night. Suddenly, a man standing in a doorway caught his attention. The man said that he was just waiting for a friend with whom he had made an appointment 20 years ago to meet at that same spot at 10 p.m. The man lit a cigar and told the lawman about his friend Jimmy Wells. As it's already quite nearly 10, the officer asked him if the man would wait any longer for Jimmy. And he replied that he would give him half an hour, and the lawman continued his patrol. About 20 minutes later, another man approached and called the waiting friend by name Bob. As the two men greeted each other heartily, Bob began to recognize some unfamiliar characteristics in his friend. He seemed taller than he remembered. Then Bob realized that the man in front of him did not have the same nose as Jimmy had. But it was far too late for him to escape arrest from the plain clothes man posing as Jimmy. Before taking him into the custody, however, the officer handed Bob a note from patrolman Wells, whom he had unwittingly met earlier. One who came before was actually his friend Bob, who was a policeman. One who came before was actually his friend Jimmy Wells, who was a policeman. He realized that Bob was the Silky Bob, who was a wanted criminal in the North. Jimmy admitted that he recognized Bob's face from a Chicago police bulletin, but did not have the heart to arrest him himself.